In this video, we're not only going to create student objects and use attributes with default values, but we're going to show you exactly why. By creating first the student using dictionaries and then seeing how we can do it with objects. By the end of this video, you will not only understand how to create student objects, but you will fully understand why we do. We start off with simple dictionaries. Imagine we're going to create a student. We want some type of student ID number to identify them, and then we have some variables. Well, we want more than one student, so we're going to have to create dictionaries for each one. So we might have a name, like a nickname, a student's real name, maybe first name, surname, have a department, advisor, and units, maybe a dictionary with the key of the student ID, and then a list of units that they're enrolled on. Now, we've just created a student called Sai, with the real name, computer department, advisor, and units. And now we're just going to print those, and we can see we've got the student details. So we could create as many students as we want using these dictionaries. Now, we're not likely to just create one student, we're likely to create many. So we're going to end up with perhaps a function such as create students, or maybe get students from a database. So we've already got the code, and also we want to print students. So we may obviously do something more complex, but to show this example, we can see, let's take the number. Let's put that in the create student as well. Okay, so we've got create students and print students. So when we print the student, so we need to pass it these dictionaries. So we're going to start off needing the student details. So we're going to do create student. Now we may pass it the number, but in this example, let's just say we don't. So create student. So we've created this student. So we need to return. We need to return the number and name and real name and department and advisor and units. So we're going to return them. And then when we call the create student, we've got all of these dictionaries and number. So now we want to print the students. So we print students, and then again we've got all of these dictionaries that we're passing. Now the point of this, we can see that when we create the student, we're passing a lot of dictionaries. So we already have a problem once we scale up something. The more different attributes, if you like, of the student, the more dictionaries we have to create, and the more we're passing. So even though this is a very simple example, you can see that we're actually passing a lot of dictionaries. So we've got print students take zero position arguments, but six was given. So again, you can see that it's quite simple to make an error. So let's run that, and you can see that's correct now. So we've got a problem with the maintenance of this code. Already it's looking complicated in a very simple example. So in this case, would it not be easier just to create a student object? In the first video, we looked at how to create a class. So let's look at how we might create a student. So we start off defining, remember underscore underscore init for initialize, and then we have this function initialize, and we had the self. Now what do we have here? We have the name of the student, we have the real name, we had the department, we had the advisor, and we had the classes, the units. Okay, so we can start off by student one, and we also had the number, so that's like the student ID. So let's start off with zero. So we've got student equals student to create a new student. So now we could pass that object quite easily if we wanted to write functions. Now with classes we could write methods inside the class, or we could write functions outside. We have a choice. But first let's have a look at these attributes. Let's look at the attributes we created before. We had the student number. So when a student's registered, they need this number. So when we create a student, what we really need to put this number in. So we can put in number into the function init. So when we create a student, we have to put the number in. Now, what about nickname? Do we need nickname when we register the student? Perhaps not. And their real name? Perhaps we do need to put their real name in. So let's create real name and that equals real. So we're going to use self to create these, and we can create them without giving them a value to start off with. When we register them, do we need, let's put the real name in. Okay, do we need the department? We can decide which attributes we need at the start and which attributes we can put in later. Like for example, we won't know units at the start. Okay, so we're going to start off with these attributes needed when we create the student. So we need name, real name, department, and advisor. So we've got number, name, we're going to create their nickname, their real name, their department. Remember, we don't necessarily have to use the same variable names as we do inside the class. So here we've got real and real name, but we do need to put self. So we can use self, and we've got the advisor, and the units we can create at a later date. So we can create units, but we're just going to create an empty list. So when we want to create the student's units, we can create them to that actual student rather than all students. So we can say units equals and then give that the value. So let's say these units. Okay, so now we have the class student, we have the created student, and we create the units later. So we can choose what we want to create when we create the student. Now let's just add some print statements to check this is okay. So we created these print statements that just print each of the student attributes, and we can see we've got the student details correctly. Now, something we can do is add default values. So let's just imagine the department is, the default is CS. So we're always going to put the students into CS unless we tell the code to put a different department. So the department will equal CS, and unless we give it a different department, that's what department will happen. Okay, now there's an error here, so we can run the code and there will be an error. And you can see non-default argument follows default argument. So what does that mean? Well, how do we know this CS is a department? When we have a default like department, it has to be at the end. So if we have any non-default arguments like advisor, they become before the default. So here, these attributes we're going to create when we create the student, but department we don't need to put in a value. It's a default value. So if we create the student, we can create that without putting the department in. If we want to change the department or give it a different department, we can. You can see here CS is now changed to EN. If we take that out, this student will go into the CS computer science department. So we can put in default values, but if we put them in, we have to make sure that they're at the end when we create the student object in the initial method. So here, I'm going to take out Codie. And when we run this, you can see we still have the same code, but we have the default values. So there we have values that we start with when we create the student. We have default values when we create the student object, and we have values that we can add later. Now, if we're going to print the details, we probably want a method inside the class. So, for example, these print statements, we could move them into a function inside the actual class. So let's say print details, and we just need the self, because all of these values will work inside the class. So we're going to take out these print statements, and then we're going to create them inside the class. So we've got print num, name, real name, department, advisor, units, with the self written beforehand. And then we can create the student details. We can print their details by just calling that function. So we run the code, and again, we've got the student. So we could again create another student. Let's call this student 2, and they've got very similar details. Let's call this John. Let's call the student John. And now when we want to print the details of the second student, this is straightforward. So now we've got the first student details and the second student details. So we can create a student, one student, quite straightforward. And once we've created the code, creating another student is very straightforward, very easy to do. Help us continue with these videos by clicking like. And these videos are in a series that we will put in a playlist if you want to watch them. So if you want to keep up to date with the new videos, please subscribe and turn on the notifications.